Hey guys, this is Mitch with Finepoint CGI, and today we're going to talk about some of the debugging options that are available inside of Godot for Android. So we're going to talk about two major debugging options, remote debugging and ADB LogCat. Really, both of them have their own place and both of them are useful, but I really think that remote debugging will change your guys' debugging life forever, really, as long as you use Godot. So that's what I have in store for you guys today. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so to use remote debugging, it's actually really simple. So this tutorial should be really quick for you guys. What you first need to do is you need to set up your application to export out to Android, which in my case, you can see here, I can export out to Android. You can actually get my device ID and all of that right here. So that's one thing that you will need to make sure that you have done already. But if you've already done that, let's go ahead and show you guys how to go about remote debugging. So what you can do is you can come up to debug and you make sure that you check deploy with remote debug right here. So you make sure you have this checked on. And if you have this checked on, remote debugging will work. Now, one of the coolest things about this is if we go ahead and we open up our character script here and we hit enter and we type print hello world and we go ahead and save this and I drop a breakpoint here, okay? If I hit Android, what's going to happen is you will see in about a few seconds once it dumps out to my Android phone that I can actually step through my code as I'm running it on my Android device. So I don't have to run it locally for me to be able to step through my code. There we go. For some reason, it didn't catch on that hello world, but you can see it stopped and broke on my code and I can actually step right through it. And you can see me walking through my code. And this is without me having anything executed on my Godot side. So this is super useful for debugging your project. So if I go ahead and get rid of this little breakpoint here, I hit play and I let it run. Some other major cool features that you can do is A, you can look at your errors, if there are any errors, or your output. So you can see here all these hello worlds from the physics process that we're doing right now. If I go to my debugger, you can see if any errors pop up, they'll show here. If you go to debugger, you can actually see all of your step through and things like that. We've gone through that before. If you go to your profiler, you can actually hit start and you can actually see how the game reacts and how the game is in terms of performance inside of Godot. So instead of needing to do profiling on the device or something like that, you can actually just do it with inside of Godot. So you can see if I turn on like idle time or physics time or anything like that. Now this game is really simple, so there really isn't much going on here, but it does give you a lot of really cool features. And you can actually look at like average time and frame percentage, right? What's drawing your frame percentage. You can see like the physics frame is actually using more than the rest, which is fine. Physics frame percentage. So you can see that the frame time is basically being taken up by the physics frame. That's what's slowing everything down. That's okay. You can do time inclusive itself. So that's really awesome. If we go to network profiler, we can actually hit network profiler and turn it on and we can see what kind of data is coming in and out of our project. So all of this is available to us. You can see I'm monitoring my FPS here while I'm running the project inside of Android, which is an awesome feature. And you guys should totally check it out when you're debugging your projects. This is something that I didn't even know existed until recently. So I really suggest that you guys take a look at it. It saves you so much time when you're debugging a problem. You can see like, oh, this is using 200 megabytes of RAM. So you could look at it and go, maybe I should make that smaller, right? So it uses up less RAM, right? If I'm over a specific usage, as a matter of fact, this is my biggest RAM usage item. It actually is something that I should reduce in size. But you guys get what I'm trying to say. So, yeah, I mean, that's the simple fact of remote debugging for Android. It really is going to save you guys a lot of trouble. Now, the next major thing that I like to do when I do my debugging is I like to use a tool called ADB LogCat. Now, you may need to go ahead and set up your ADB LogCat. If you haven't, what you need to do is you need to go to your system environment variables, and you can kind of go ahead and take a look at them. Go to your environment variables, and then from here, you can go ahead and try to find your ADB LogCat inside of your path here. So if I go ahead and I edit this, and I scroll down, there should be a section here that I have set up specifically for ADB LogCat. I believe it's under C users, your username, app data, Android SDK platform tools. So if we head out to that general direction here, so if I go to C, I believe it's C users, my name, app data, local Android SDK, and if I remember correctly, platform tools. And there it is, ADB right here. So you want this tool to be installed. And if this isn't installed, you need to install the Android Studio, and it will go ahead and install all of these nice features here for you. So now if I open up a command prompt here and I type ADB LogCat, you will see it is popping out a bunch of hello worlds from Godot. You can see all those wonderful hello worlds. But you'll notice that it's polluted data with a lot of additional data that's inside of our Android device. So if I scroll up and I kind of get to a spot where there's a little bit more information here, you can see when you're debugging through ADB LogCat, it doesn't quite give you just Godot information. It says Godot hello world, but it also says stuff like compat change ID reported, number UID status enabled, right? So what you can do is you can filter that by typing ADB LogCat dash S space Godot, enter. And what it'll do is it'll only show Godot messages. So that's something that you could totally use to debug your project. Now, generally speaking, remote debug is going to be better than ADB LogCat, but ADB LogCat is huge when you're trying to debug a small problem, especially if it goes outside of your project. That means you'd have to get rid of your dash S here and just pull all of the data, but it could be super useful for things like, oh, I sent out a request and I never got information back from the Android subsystem, right? This can tell you potentially what you did wrong, and it can save you a lot of trouble. Something I forgot to mention is there's a really cool feature in a... Something I forgot to mention in the first recording of this video was a really cool feature with ADB LogCat where you can actually pipe it into a file. So if you come in here and you type ADB LogCat and then you use a greater than symbol and you type in whatever you want to call it. So in my case, I'll just call it logtest.txt. If you hit enter, you'll notice that nothing prints on the screen. And that is because if we come over to, in my case, C users username, right? You can come over here. You can find that there is a log test file here. So if I refresh it, you'll see that it has some data in it. If we actually right click on it and we open it, you can see that it has all sorts of data here from my Android runtime. So instead of needing to go in and let's say I was looking, so for instance, if I was looking for a specific log in all of this, usually what you would do is you'd wait until it got to this point, you'd right click or control, you'd click on it, control A, control C, right? So you'd control A, control C, And then you'd open up something like Visual Studio Code, and then you'd paste it in. Whereas if you do the piping method, which is what that's called, you can actually just pipe it in directly and you have it already in a file for you. So that's just something to keep in mind, and it's super useful. So I thought I'd butt in and talk about it. Now, the last major feature that we got to look at is if we go up to debug and small deploy with network file system. Now, in my case, it's not really going to help very much because my project is tiny. But if you turn this on, what will happen is when you build out your project, it'll only build out an executable without your project data. So basically, it'll just put out the executable with the code itself, and then it will download the data it needs to execute from your local host here or from your machine here. So that can really help when your project's really large and things like that, and it'll really make multiple deployments much faster, especially if you're redeploying on your mobile device. You know, a lot of times when you're making changes to help make your game better, you have to deploy it 6 or 7 times before it gets to where you want it to be. So this can really help with reducing wait times, especially if it's a big project, because sometimes projects that are large take forever to transfer. But anyway, that's all there really is to debugging inside of Android. So we talked about remote debugging with the profiler and with looking at the different debug, you know, systems that you can use, the monitors and the video RAM and things like that. We also talked about ADB LogCat and how useful that can be. And we talked about what deploy with remote debug is and what small deploy with network file system is. So, yeah. I mean, that's all I have for you guys today. So if you like this video, go ahead and hit that like button. Hey, you know, if you dislike this video, go ahead and hit that dislike button, because I am here to make content for you guys. This video was a viewer suggestion, so I always take your suggestions very seriously. And if you guys have any suggestions, throw them in the comments below, and I'll be more than happy to talk to you about them and, you know, make videos that you guys want. And hey, you know, if you have any questions about this or have any trouble, let me know in the comments below or hit me up on the Discord, and I'll be more than happy to help you guys out. Link is in the description below. But that's all I have for you guys today. So thank you so much again for watching, and I will see you all next time. Thanks.